Hello guys, good morning, good afternoon, or good evening. This is Jesus Loves You channel, where we'll be giving you latest updates on what's going on in Nigeria. On the news today, Delta community cries out over attack by herdsmen. So guys, before we go into full details on this news, I would love for you to hit on the red subscribe button down below, and also don't forget to click on the notification bell so you can get updates when we upload new videos. Moving on into the news, residents of Ise Lasaba community in Anocha North local government area of Delta State have cried out over the incessant attacks on the community by suspected Fulani herdsmen in the last 4 months, and called on President Muhammadu Buhari to come to their rescue. Addressing newsmen on the situation, President General of the Ise Lasaba Development Union, Mr. Ben Ilo, said that the suspected Fulani herdsmen have killed 4 members of the community and kidnapped several persons who were freed after the payment of ransom in the separate attacks. According to him, residents of the town no longer sleep with their eyes closed. He therefore appealed to President Muhammadu Buhari to prevail on the various security agencies to liberate them. He lamented that the situation has overwhelmed the local vigilante group. According to Ilo, these attacks have become a very big problem to us. Teachers are afraid to go and teach. It took serious effort to get some of them back to school, as the presence of vigilante operatives gave them the courage to go to school. The community youth leader, Mr. Ogebu Edozie, who also spoke with newsmen, said, "Ise Lasaba is very receptive to strangers, irrespective of tribe or religion. But bandits have taken advantage of such hospitality to unleash terror on us." Edozie insisted that armed Fulani herdsmen were responsible for the series of attacks on the community, noting that those who have encountered the hoodlums, including three kidnapped victims, confirmed that the attackers were Fulani, going by the language which they spoke and their physical appearance. Since October 13th last year, when the suspected Fulani herdsmen launched the first attack on the community by invading the Ise Lasaba Secondary School and kidnapped the school's principal and some teachers after beating security at the gate, the community has not known peace. It has been more or less 1 week, one trouble for residents of the community. On the 23rd of February, the suspected Fulani herdsmen stormed the community, attacked the residents of one Daniel Benwari, shot sporadically, killed the man who was said to be of Ijo and Urobo ethnic extraction, injured his daughter, and kidnapped the wife, Helen Benwari. Few days later, the wife was released with serious body injuries after undisclosed amount of ransom was paid. She was immediately taken to the Federal Medical Center, Asaba, where the daughter was also taken to for treatment. Again, the suspected Fulani herdsmen on the 4th of March besieged the community, killed the manager of a brothel, names withheld, in the community and kidnapped 8 persons. Meanwhile, the State Commissioner of Police, Mr. Hafiz Inua, has vowed to rid the state of criminal elements, including armed Fulani herdsmen, terrorizing communities in the state. Inua said he was determined to change the narratives of crime and criminal activities in the state, maintaining that vigilante groups were playing a pivotal role in assisting the police to fight crime, especially at the grassroots. So guys, that is it on this news. So guys, you can see what is going on now. These Fulani herdsmen, they will not stop till they infiltrate all of Nigeria. Every day they keep on finding communities to destroy, people to kidnap. These are people's lives that are being destroyed, and yet the government still denies it, that it is Fulani herdsmen that are causing this, when the people that they even kidnap self are saying that it's Fulani herdsmen. Are they so difficult that somebody cannot identify them? Our government prefers cows to human lives, because that is what they use to make money. This is security concerning the Fulani herdsmen or the Boko Haram will not end, because our government cannot be distracted by the fact that their citizens are feeling insecure. They are concerned with looting as much as they can get their hands on. So anybody or any state that is hoping that the government will come to their rescue, they are living in La La Land. They are dreaming. If you even look at this issue, you'll be asking yourself, Where are these people getting these guns from? How come they are fully armed? How come they are prepared? Or do these people have agenda? What is their motive behind all this kidnapping, raping? Is it that is what they train them to do? So the state government should not just be saying they will protect their people, this and that. They should ask the real question. Why are all these things happening? What is their main purpose? What is their agenda? Because if people are not careful, very soon, this will be the daily habit of these people. Because it is obvious they know that the government is backing them up. So they continue doing what they like. How can you go to another man's land and you start disrupting their life? It does not make sense. That is to show you that these people know what they are doing. So guys, we just have to be careful and responsible for our own security. Moving on to the next news. Anambra 2021, APGA distances party from Soludo others. The All Progressive Grand Alliance has said a former governor of the Central Bank of Nigeria, Professor Charles Soludo, had not informed the party of his reported intention to vie for the governorship of Anambra State in 2021. The Anambra State chairman of APGA, Mr. Norbert Obi, said this during a stakeholders' meetings of the party at INRI at the Anocha local government area of the state. The Anambra State chairman of APGA, Mr. Norbert Obi, said as of the time he was addressing the stakeholders, nobody had informed the party of Soludo's aspiration to contest the 2021 election. The former CBN governor and an Onitsha-based estate surveyor and valuer/lawyer, Damian Okolo, both from the southern senatorial zone of the state, are among those who are said to be nursing the 2021 governorship election. Speaking at the stakeholders' meeting, the APGA chairman said party leaders only heard about the aspirations of these individuals in the media. He said, no single person has visited the party office to announce his or her governorship aspiration. People of substances are joining APGA in large numbers, and it is a welcome development. We have heard of so many of them wanting to contest for governor in 2021. But nobody has told us he's contesting for anything. As far as APGA is concerned, they are on their own for now. Until such people come to the party secretariat to inform us of their aspiration, we do not know who is going to contest what. He said the leadership of APGA was at Justice Peter's Umedi's Inri's home to celebrate his 1 year of joining APGA, and not that the ex-chief judge had expressed interest in contesting any elective office. Umedi, who hosted over 800 women from the 326 political wards in the state, said he would not vie for a public office, but did not state the office he was eyeing. Umedi said, 1 year ago, I joined APGA. After 1 year of being a member of the party, I should begin to build my political structure. And that is why I invited women from all the 179 autonomous communities in the state to introduce myself to them as a starting point. I joined the party just as an individual who did not have any political structure, and I know that for me to realize my political ambition, I need to build a formidable structure. So guys, that is basically it on this news. I would love to conclude with the fact that I love the idea of a new party coming up. We are tired of APC. We are tired of PDP. We are tired of their campaign never-ending promises that they don't even fulfill anyone. So it is a good thing that there's a show of face of another party, especially in Anambra State, where there's always war between PDP and APC. But what we are really hoping for is that by 2023, when election comes, we don't even want to be talking about one Nigeria. We don't want to be talking about having APC or PDP. We want to talk about having a new government. We want a new system of government. If anybody is thinking that a change of party will make a better government in Nigeria, they are just plainly deceiving themselves. Any party that is coming up now will still do the same thing that APC did or PDP did, because once they are in power, their campaigns' ideas will change. They will no longer focus on the promises that they made. So guys, I would love to hear your own opinion down in the comment section below. And also don't forget to like, subscribe and share this video so that other people can watch it too. Thank you for supporting this channel, and we pray that as you support this channel, you'll be supported in whatever business you're doing. Bye bye.